This news just in, Singapore has confirmed two new cases of the novel coronavirus, taking its total now to 30. One of the cases has no travel history to mainland China and no known links to other local cases. However, contact tracing is still underway. We'll have more details on this story in a while. First, though, employers will have to notify the Manpower Ministry if they have workers coming back from China so it can stagger their return and manage the flow. This was announced by National Development Minister Lawrence Wong on the sidelines of a visit to a workers' dormitory. He also said businesses who have returning workers serving a mandatory leave of absence will get support. All this as Singapore steps up enforcement to contain the spread of this novel coronavirus. Vanessa Lim with more.
Those returning from China who are placed on a 14-day leave of absence could face more stringent checks to ensure they stay home and minimize their contact with others. This could be similar to what's being done for quarantine orders.
We already have a series of very strict surveillance measures when it comes to home quarantine, whether it's through phone calls, spot checks, video calls, and then we can make use of similar technologies and measures to do the monitoring and surveillance. And then, of course, when it comes to penalties and fines or whatnot, then we will have to see what are the appropriate penalties.
Mr. Wong said these could also include revoking work permit privileges. He also announced other measures during a visit to a foreign workers' dormitory in Tuas with Manpower Minister Josephine Teo. For instance, employers will need to inform the Manpower Ministry of their workers' return from China in advance. But Mr. Wong added that the government is mindful of the impact of these moves on businesses, which is why they will receive $100 a day for each worker who's put on a leave of absence and a waiver of their foreign worker levy. That's equivalent to the help given for quarantine orders. Besides this, the government is working with dormitory operators to provide facilities for workers who are unable to find suitable accommodation to serve their leave of absence. As of last week, about 30,000 work pass holders from China had yet to return. Mrs. Teo said the majority are still out of Singapore.
There will also be companies that, in order to keep their business going, need to bring back the workers. And they will look to the government support in this process. We would like to be able to help them also, because if their operations can't continue, then it will also eventually affect their local employees.
Mr. Wong said the government is working out a package of measures to help them further. This will be announced during the budget, which will take place in about 2 weeks' time.